is ever. Maybe she can.
Oh my god.
Well, you ruined it.
You trying to scare me?
I was going
to
come behind you and give a kiss on the cheek.
Everybody's talking about the kiss.
The kiss. Kiss.
The kiss was quite, you know, it was fun.
해리포터 시리즈에서 총 5번의 키스씬이 등장하는데요. 배우들이 사춘기를 거치며 성장하면서 촬영했기 때문에 이 키스씬들의 촬영에는 수많은 뒷이야기가 있었습니다. 비하인드 영상과 함께 각 장면들의 소설과 영화의 차이점도 설명해 드리도록 하겠습니다. 가장 처음에 등장하는 키스씬은 해리와 초의 키스로 5편인 불사조 기사단에서 나옵니다.
I think everyone's sort of waiting for is the sort of Harry's first kiss and I'm quite excited. I know I'll be really, really nervous, but it's great because, you know, Katie's beautiful and I don't even have to make an effort to try and make her fancy me because she has to kiss me because it's in the script.
It's been written in the script.
Yes, so that's one of the bonuses of being Harry.
God, the idea of kissing someone on screen is terrifying.
Well,
do you not
know.
Find that really scary?
Oh, I think that's... I'm quite, as I said, I'm quite looking forward to it.
그럼 이 둘의 키스신 비하인드를 함께 보시죠.
It was a great scene. I really enjoyed it. I was so nervous before. I think Daniel was as well.
Because we were both nervous, and we both knew we were nervous, it made it a lot easier, if you know what I mean, because we both knew how we felt and we were both a bit embarrassed.
You just let yourselves go, completely relax.
They made sure that the set was closed and there was minimal people inside, and they sort of dimmed the lights. I don't know if it was so it would be less intimidating or if it was going to be more romantic.
I think my glasses hit you that time, sorry.
It's quite a clinical sort of thing because you sort of be in the kissing position and someone will say, Dan, move to your right. All right. And you'll sort of do that. And it's just a very odd thing to do.
When I say now, you'll just start to kiss on the other side. So you'll just swivel around, yeah?
I mean, it would be a nightmare if you're actually kissing someone and someone said, move to your left. It would be bizarre.
Roll camera, please.
It was a bit awkward at the beginning, but... You know, the more we did it, the more we just got used to it, and it was fine.
Bum?
It's fine now.
I know, it's cool now, and it's like we're really cool.
It's a very odd thing to watch, because it's kind of like watching your own children, but it's not. But you still feel a great sort of paternal instinct.
Good night to Dan and Katie. Well done, guys.
Much of the crew has been on the film since Dan was 10, 11 years old, and to see him now going through this romantic moment was rather beautiful and wonderful, but at the same time, you felt like you shouldn't be in the room watching.
해리의 첫 키스신으로 어렸을 때부터 다니엘이 크는 걸 지켜봤던 팬들에게 꽤나 충격적인 장면이었죠. 프로듀서와 스태프들에게도 마찬가지였던 것 같네요. 봐서는 안 되는 걸 보는 느낌이었다니 그만큼 다니엘을 자기 자식같이 아꼈다는 말이겠죠.
That's a huge moment, actually. I think there's a lot of girls, especially, will be waiting for that moment.
It was actually great. It was really, really cool. And I'm sure, you know, anyone who's seen the film will agree that Katie's quite beautiful. So I felt very privileged, really.
I'll not kiss you enough today, but I thought that's a...
Daniel is a very good kisser. Thank God.
Now, well done. We've done it now. It's done. There we go.
두 번째는 혼혈왕자에서 나온 논과 라벤더의 키스신인데요. 다니엘과 케이티는 두 편의 영화를 촬영하는 동안 서로를 알아왔지만 루퍼트와 제시는 만난 지 며칠 안 지나서 키스신 촬영을 했다고 합니다. 다니엘이 키스신을 촬영했을 당시 루퍼트가 놀려댔다고 하는데 이를 복수하려고 다니엘은 일부러 시간을 내서 촬영장에 나타났다고 하네요.
was very much excited about Ron scenes with Lavender because I took a fair bit of stick when I kissed Katie in the last film, so it was time for revenge this time around.
Daniel Radcliffe was definitely there. His presence was known on the kissing scene day. I think he even came back when he wasn't on camera just to be there.
그런데 여기서 의문점. 영화를 보면 론과 라벤더가 키스를 하는 장면에서 해리와 헤르미온느가 같이 있는 것처럼 보이지만 다니엘을 찍을 땐 앞에 조명이 있고 그의 주위에 주요 캐릭터인 네빌, 딘 그리고 지니가 있는 걸 보면 따로 촬영했던 걸로 보입니다. 반면에 루퍼트와 제시는 수많은 엑스트라와 함께 촬영을 한 거죠. 쉽게 말해 루퍼트의 키스신 촬영장에 다니엘은 없어도 되지만 그저 루퍼트를 놀려주기 위해 다니엘이 온 거죠.
I took days to calm down. I don't think Rupert had done a kissing scene. That was entirely new territory for him.
he was actually quite lucky because when he did his scene, he was on his own. He was just him and Katie. This time in the scene, it's pretty packed, so a little bit more embarrassing, I think. But I just said to try and get over it.
Really nice to see Ron's first kind of experience of this girl and having a kiss. I wasn't really aware of the fact that there would be around 70 or 80 extras.
Okay, okay, okay.
But actually, I think that probably made it easier.
It's just such a weird sort of thing. You've got everyone watching you, and it's just didn't feel very sort of natural.
For me, the only awkward part was the rehearsal where it was just me, David, and Rupert. And so that was way more intimate than this kind of scene of all these people. This cheering noise going on. So I don't think how happy Rupert was about it, but I think it went okay. I hope it went okay. I was more concerned anyway about honestly chipping a tooth. I really was worried.
Queen, 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 Queen,
Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen,
Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, Queen, what it was to be like, but I think it's difficult to kind of prepare yourself because you'll never know what it's like until it's over.
That was kind of odd, because when Katie Leung as Cho was cast, she was brought in and we were already aware that she ultimately was the love interest. Whereas Bonnie, it was kind of odd because I've known Bonnie since she was about 10, so it's a bit weird doing all that, but it's fine.
Katie와 다르게 지니 역을 맡은 보니는 다니엘과 함께 마법사의 돌부터 시작한 원년 멤버입니다. 서로 어렸을 때부터 봐서 그런지 친구끼리의 키스신이라 기분이 이상했다고 하네요.
Let's roll, please.
Victor 54, take one. But I think the first time is always the worst, but after that it's just like any other scene that you're filming, so it was actually easier than I realised as it went on.
Three on the end.
Yeah, I think at first, when everyone comes in and have a look at the scene, you know, lighting or the crew, it's a bit embarrassing, but I think after a while, you just got to accept it and get on.
Key is just connecting with that.
Sure. I think people, they want to tease you, but then they don't really want to make you really more awkward about it. So I think people were quite relaxed. I think it's also something that's quite hard to bring up to someone because you don't really want to make them more awkward than they probably already are.
I think everyone's tried to be kind about it because it's embarrassing enough, or it's difficult enough as it is. Dan's known Bonnie for a long time, and then having to kind of kiss someone, it's quite a weird thing to have to do. So I think everyone's kind of tried to cut each other some slack and just kind of give everyone the space to kind of try and do a good job, I think.
I was talking with other people about kind of all those different things, you know, eat loads of garlic and fish and different things, but that's really cruel, so I did not for that one.
이 장면은 영화와 소설이 완전히 다릅니다. 아니, 소설의 해리와 지니의 관계가 훨씬 더 설득력 있다고 봐야죠. 영화에서는 피로의 방에서 은밀하게 키스를 했다면 소설에서는 키디치 우승을 하고 모두가 보는 앞에서 키스를 합니다. 영화에서의 론과 라벤더의 키스처럼요. 이 장면에서 헤르미온느, 론, 그리고 딘까지 보는 앞이었기 때문에 이들의 캐릭터 관계가 참 재밌었거든요. 반면에 영화에서의 키스신은 그저 해리와 지니가 서로 좋아한다는 걸 직접적으로 보여주는 장면으로만 보이고 해리와 지니 모두 너무 수동적이라 밋밋한 느낌도 듭니다. 영화라는 매체로서 2시간 정도의 시간 안에 스토리를 진행하려면 많은 걸 편집해야 했겠지만 지니란 멋진 캐릭터를 너무 안 보여준 것 같아 원작 팬으로서 너무 아쉽네요. 네 번째는 해리와 헤르미온느의 키스로 이 장면은 실제 일어난 일이 아니라 호크룩스를 파괴하려 할 때 론의 상상에서 일어난 일이죠.
Well, obviously kissing Dan, kissing Harry for that scene, you know, it's a figment of Ron's imagination and the worst possible thing that he could ever imagine. So the kiss obviously had to be passionate. I was half naked and covered in silver paint. So that was pretty awkward.
이 키스 씬을 촬영할 땐 로버트가 이들을 구경했는데 그는 너무 웃겨서 웃음을 멈출 수 없었다고 합니다. 이에 참지 못한 엠마가 루퍼트를 촬영장에서 쫓아냈다고 하네요.
Kissing Rupert also awkward. We'd just been soaked by an enormous bucket of water which was sort of perched which we had to pretend we didn't know was going to hit us but we knew was coming and that was also equally awkward and weird. So both strange situations to be in. Both were complete gentlemen and, you know, very, it's obviously hard to put our personal history to one side, considering that we did grow up together, but I don't think they'll mind me saying that, you know, once you've done it sort of four or five times, it gets quite, like kissing gets quite boring, genuinely. So it definitely got easier.
마지막인 다섯 번째는 론과 해리미온의 키스입니다.
I always thought that Hermione and Ron would be together. Always. I always thought that she had a crush on Ron from the very beginning.
I think over the years, we're seeing a lot more depth in these characters, because obviously at this point, Ron is kind of cares a lot about Hermione. Like on the brink of falling in love.
And all this tension that's been building for the previous seven films, for the previous six and a half books, we've been desperate for the two of them to get together. And now they do.
엠마는 처음부터 헤르미온느와 론이 엮일 거라고 확신했다고 합니다. 그래서 롤링 작가에게 론과의 키스신이 있냐고 미리 물어봤다고 하네요.
I can remember being in Emma's dressing room and she said to me, I'm going to have to kiss Rupert, aren't I? And she was completely fine with this. She could see where things were going. And I said, well, actually, if they remain true to the books, you'll have to kiss both of them. And at that point, it was way too much. You know what? I had, because she'd grown up with these two boys. So, oh God, I have to kiss Dan as well. And she fell off the sofa laughing. It was so sweet.
6년이 넘는 시간 동안 티격태격했지만 서로 많이 챙겨주고 했던 둘인데 이 둘의 관계가 어떻게 끝날 것인가도 팬들 사이에서 큰 이슈였죠.
I've never got this far before. They go to the Chamber of Secrets to destroy Horcrux. The skeleton of the basilisk is still where we left it in the second one, so it's kind of eerie. That's the scene where Ron and Hermione have their little moment.
They knew it was kind of coming, because, you know, it's part of the story, it was in the script. But they worry a lot about it.
Yeah, David kind of sprang it on us.
There's a scene that we're shooting later this week that we should talk about once you've read it. So have a look at it, because we're doing the kiss this week between Ron and Hermione.
What?
Doing the kiss between Ron and Hermione in
this
in the Chamber of Secrets.
I was dreading it, to be honest.
You are not allowed to be here.
Everyone was there for my kiss.
I think just because I've known her for so long, it's kind of like 10 years.
If someone is literally like a sibling to you, you've grown up with them, being put in a situation where you have to kiss them is just really awkward.
I think we kind of built it up into this kind of really awkward, horrible kind of thing. Because there's so much anticipation with these two. Because it has been building up since the early ones. So we both wanted to do it right.
어릴 때부터 허물없이 지낸 친구 사이의 키스신이라 너무 어색해서 긴장을 많이 했다고 합니다. 거기에 많은 스태프들과 팬들이 기대하고 있기 때문에 잘해야 한다는 부담감도 있었겠죠. 이렇게 많은 감정이 섞여 있었던 촬영장이었네요.
We're rolling. We have a close set. It's always good to have a few people on the set as possible and to make it as comfortable for them as possible.
Okay guys, here we go, shooting.
Rupert was like, I don't know how we're going to do it. And I was like, I've got no idea either.
And action!
We were both more worried about the fact that we just wouldn't be able to do it.
We did have a trouble kind of keeping a straight face.
Sorry.
Yeah, it just wasn't working.
And I just said to Rupert, don't be Rupert, forget Rupert, just be Ron. Just let Ron take over in that moment. And I said the same thing to Emma, let Hermione take over in that moment. And Emma, as ever, is so smart. She knows that rather than doing 27 takes, she knew if she committed really early, we'd get it. I saw her make the decision in her eyes. I saw her think, I'm gonna have to really go for it.
I just kind of had to put the incredible amount of history that I have with Rupert aside and be Hermione.
So she really went for it, much to Rupert's surprise. She just went boom, right in there.
Doing it, they're in a huge amount of danger. They've nearly just died, and I think in that moment it's about both of them realizing, if we're gonna die tonight, the one thing I actually want to do is kiss you.
Once we did it, it was nice. I think they kind of leave some of that laughing in. Because I think it's quite a natural kind of thing.
That was great, we got it.
Yes! It's quite romantic, really. It was good. He's a nice kisser.
루퍼트에게 엠마가 키스를 잘하냐고 물어보는 인터뷰입니다.
So, yeah.
Is she a good kisser? The nation needs to know. The world needs to know.
I actually have no memory, at all. I must have kind of wiped out my... But yeah,
you're a true gentleman, clearly. You're very discreet.
이 장면은 영화 소설이 조금 다른데요. 영화에서는 후플푸프의 잔을 파괴하고 키스를 하지만 소설에서는 호그와트 전투 중 론이 집요정들이 도비처럼 죽을까 걱정을 하자 헤르미온느가 이에 감동을 받고 론에게 달려들어 키스를 합니다. 소설을 읽으셨다면 이 장면을 이해할 테지만 영화만 보면 조금 뜬금없을 거예요. 소설에서 헤르미온느는 집요정들의 자유에 대해 심할 정도로 집착을 보여주죠. 그래서 스퓨, 다시 말해 집요정 해방운동을 만들어 홀로 집요정들의 자유를 위해 일했거든요. 베프인 론과 해리마저 그녀를 지지하지 않았지만 그런 론이 집요정을 걱정하자 해리미언느는 큰 감동을 받은 것 같네요.
Compare the kiss you had with Ron and the one you had with Harry, Daniel Radcliffe, and would you have liked to kiss Tom Felton?
Should have seen this one coming. Right, so this is really difficult. I've got to try and be diplomatic. Okay, beautiful girlfriend is sitting in the left-hand corner of the room. So no, I don't think so. My 12-year-old self, absolutely, but my 21-year-old self, no.
재밌게 보셨다면 구독과 좋아요 꼭 부탁드리고 더 궁금한 점이나 공유하고 싶으신 이야기가 있으시다면 댓글로 남겨주세요. 그럼 저는 최대한 빠른 시일 내로 유익한 영상으로 다시 돌아오겠습니다. 지금까지 더블리였습니다.